Well, guys, welcome back again to our YouTube channel. And on today's video, we are going to look at how do you calculate the quantities of a door? How do you know how much timber you are going to need for your door? Let's say you want to do some cutting so that you can prepare a door. So how much timber are you going to need? This tutorial is very important for students, and it's also very important for people that are in the site or in the construction industry. So our door today is a ledger framed door, and as you can see, it has ledges. These are the top rail, this is the top rail, this is the middle rail, and this is the down here we have a bottom rail, and then the door, it has battens, and then we have the frame. So we want to see how we can get the quantities of that door. Now let's start. For the ledger and breast door, this is how the door looks like. This is the outside view. Yeah, and the inner view, and this is the outside view. So you can see on the back view, we have, this is the top rail, and then we have the mid rail, and then we have the bottom rail. Along here, the horizontal edges, there are stiles, and then we have the braces. These are the braces, and then we have, these are the battens. So let's start. We have, those are the parts that we have for that door, and then we have been given sizes of timber that are going to be required. So the door size itself is 1,000 by 2,100 by 50 millimeters, and then that is 2,100, and then the stiles and the top rail is at 100 by 50 millimeters, and then the middle and bottom rail is 225 by 325 millimeters. Now let's start with the stiles. So we have the stiles there. So these are the stiles here, those ones. So we said from this point up to this point is 2,100, yeah, and then from this point up to this point is 1,000. That was the size of the door. Now we need to get this length. So this is 2,100, we multiply by 2, that gives us 42. That gives us 4,200, and then in meter cubic will be 4,200 times 0.1 is the size of the timber. The length and the thickness is 50, so we multiply the length and the thickness to get 21 cubic meters. Then we go to the top rail. The top rail is this one here, that one. So this one is from here, this is 100. The length here is 100, and the length here is 100. So when you subtract 100, what is left here is 800. Here we have 800 from that point up to that point is 800. So 800, and then we multiply by the length of that timber is 100, and then the width is 50, that is 0.05. That gives us 0.043 cubic meters. Now let's go to the next one. We have the middle and the bottom rail. They share the same size of timber. This one and this one, they share the same size of timber. So this one is from this, the length is from that point up to that point, that is 800 millimeters. So by 2, because we have the middle and the bottom, and then that gives us 1.6. So for us to get the length in meter cubic, because we are doing the length in meter cubic, because we might be going to buy, the price in the market maybe of the timber piece maybe per meter cubic. So we have 1.6, that is the length times, this member here is 225 by the thickness is 32, so 225 is 0.225 times 0.032, that gives us 0.115 meter cubic. And then we go to the braces. For the braces, we have, the size is 100 by 32 millimeters. So these are our braces. This is the brace, that one. That is the brace that we are talking about. So let's first find this length here. This length here. So we are going to take the entire length, which is that one. That was 2,100. 2100, and then we subtract this, the top one, which is 100, and then we subtract the middle and the bottom rails, which was 225. So it's 2100 minus 100, that is the top, and then minus 225, that is the middle and the bottom. Then we divide by 2 for us to get this length here, from that point up to this point, and from this point up to the other point. So when we divide by 2, we get is 775. So this one is 775, and then this one is 800. Yeah, because it's this one from this point up to this point. Now let's find x. So we find the square root of 800 squared plus 775 squared. The square root of it is 1113, that is 1.1. Then we multiply by 2 because there are 2, this and this, that gives us 2.2. So in meter cubic will be 2.22 times 0.1, that is the length, and then the thickness is 0.032, that gives us 0.007 meter cubic. And then we go to the next one. The next one are the battens. The battens are, the size are 75 by 18 millimeters. How many are they? So the battens are running from here up to here. As you can see, these members that are running here. Yes, those ones. Now, we divide by the length, one of them from here up to here, the same as from here up to here is 75. So we divide by 75 to get how many are they. So in this case, they are 11. So the length will be from here up to the bottom of the bottom rail. So we just take 2100, that is the entire length, and then we minus the top rail, that is 100, that gives us 2 meters. So the length will be 11 by 2 meters, and then by the length 0.75, and then by the thickness 0.018, that gives us 0.293. So if you have those lengths, you can be able to know the how many pieces you will need and how you are going to do your cutting. Or now with the length, you can multiply by the recent cost of the softwood timber for you to get the quantity, the unit cost of that frame laid brace and battened door. So guys, thank you for your time and thank you for watching. Until next time, bye bye.